Steph.
Welcome to KPTV.
Here we are, born to be kings. We're the princes of the universe. Here we belong.
And Westfields with all the first run of the day.
Away from the Keebra Park line, Ezekiel. Able to run again, Lee Harrington. By Herman Retzlaff.
Herminator
to come up with it with Payne. Helmet up and then a huge tackle.
And gets it. Oh! Welcome to Suncorp. Just Moses on the callum.
Out they come with Ferrati. He's picked up and driven.
With the whistle this afternoon, we are all set, ready to go. We have waited some time for this clash, and it's underway right now here on the News Network. Round 4 of the Alan Langer Trophy, and Albedino will carry the ball first up for the Reds. Two 30-minute halves here at round 4, 1 versus 3, an almighty clash, and both sides coming off wins. So couldn't get any better here at Owen Park, and for Palm Beach Currumbin fans, they'd be quite happy with that penalty. Palm Beach, they were challenged last week up against St. Mary's down the road at Pizzy Park, but at the end of the day, they were just too good, putting them away in the second half, 16 points to 6. It was a gallant effort from St. Mary's, but Palm Beach Currumbin showed why they're on top of the ladder at the moment as Bailey Martin brings the ball into Keebra Park territory. Udebergen, left-hand side. And now this is Willison, who brings the ball forward. Tackled 10 after halfway. Expecting a big game. Sadly, no crowd here at Owen Park. There is a fair contingent outside. There's a big hit there from, I think it was Talia, the 5'8", putting a shot on. That's what you like to see. And they'll play the ball now. Weaver out the back. Rivet finding Albedino again. Working towards the centre of the post. Tackle 4 here for Palm Beach Currumbin. Back to Udebergen. Now Rivet inside. That's Brock Priestley. Carries the ball forward now. It's a good run from him. Last tackle. They go to the right. Rivet puts a kick on. It's deflected a few times. Picked up though, Keebra Park. Levi Jones has the footy only a couple of metres outside his own line. And now a yardage set coming up for Keebra Park. They'd love a penalty just to work their way and assist them in working their way out of their own ends. And they get it. Well, the reprieve, the second penalty of the match. Ipswich yet to win a game challenging Keebra Park. But the boys from the coast were able to hold their own and pick up the 2 points. It North Ipswich Reserve last Wednesday. This is now Matt Alavea Booth with the footy. He's about 38 metres from his own line. They come out of dummy half. Gunn James goes to ground. Adamson out of dummy half. Finds their prop forward. 3 points last week, I believe, Herman Tofeono in the Justin Hodges medal. A lovely inside ball. Gunn James is away, breaks the line, gets a late offload to Adamson. And they'll go to ground here. Here's the last now for Keebra Park. Adamson goes to their halves. Talia. Oh, it's been juggled there by Troy Duckett. He played on the wing last week for PBC, wanting first points in this Gold Coast derby. They go through to Carney. Out the back west. They get numbers around the ball, though. They'll lose some metres in this first tackle. Adamson coming in a dummy half. To Carney. Takes the line on. He gets it away. It's Wood. Down 5 away. Anderson quickly out of dummy half. Kicks for the corner. Crafty, but great defence from Duckett on his own goal line. But 25 degrees. Not too much of a breeze at the moment. What a dropout. That is 255 metres on the fly. And now for the big prop forward in Tofeono. Carries the ball forward for Keebra Park. First up, Now for Gun James. Been busy early in the middle of the park, as you'd expect. It's Adamson. Plays the ball out to Takani. Out the back. West chimes in again. He's been busy early, the fullback. He'll now go to grounds. 18 metres short of Palm Beach Currumbin's line. Now for Matalavea Booth. Just a nice settler. Plays it quickly. Back to Adamson again. West. A long ball out. Levi Jones adds try number 4 to his tally so far this season. And Keebra Park will draw first blood here this afternoon in this round 4 derby. Lines up. Strikes it. Well, unfortunately, it's gone right off the post. So it remains a 4-point ball game here at Southport. They'll then obviously play off in the Alan Langer Trophy final, and the winner will take on the winner of the Aaron Payne Cup for the prestigious Phil Hall Cup in late September here at Southport Tigers. So now, Keebra Park again, a great carry forward. Plenty of ascendancy from them as Gun James plays the ball back to Adamson again. They go through the hands. That's Calm Pereira. The late change, as we said, in jersey 12 now in the back row for Keebra Park this afternoon. To Leah. And now Tofeano. He goes to ground looking for the quick play the ball. Adamson asking questions out the back. Through the hands. A lovely break there from Wood. Straight through. Numbers around him as well. Offloads. Lachlan West will go over for try 2. Pretty much in exactly the same spot as where Levi Jones scored only a couple of minutes ago. As Connor Takani looks better this time round, but it just goes left of the left upright. The score 8-0 here at Owen Park on the Gold Coast. Round 4 of the Alan Langer Trophy. Now the message, I'm sure, for Palm Beach here, just boys, defend our line. That's a huge kick, massive. It's not much of a breeze, so that has probably gone about 65 on the fly. It's had to have gone at least 60 metres, so probably, yeah, 65, 70 metres on the fly. And not what Palm Beach by St. Mary's. But they were able to hold their own. Just the one try conceded in the second half. I don't think Palm Beach Currumbin, and particularly coach Brad Davis, would have been too impressed with the way they finished the game. Last week, Palm Beach Currumbin. They've got a switch on here with Keebra Park, the early 8-point lead. And this dominant football side. I mean, we all remember their 2017 season. The likes, David Fifita, of course, to the Titans next year. Payne Haas, just to name a few players. They go out the back. Lockie West wasn't expecting that. They're able to keep the ball, though. Jareem Buller straightens things up here for Keebra Park. Now for Talia. Playing it quickly, Adamson. Gun James. Straight through the park, dragging defenders, trying to get his hand free to go over the line. McCall will be held up. That's a great carry. He has had a fantastic opening 12 minutes of the game, has Tyrone Gun James in the middle of the park. So now, out the back, kicks it, does Takani. Is it too deep? They're going to claim a try, and Buller is going to score. Again, the left-hand side, PBC's right-hand defence being questioned this afternoon. And now all of a sudden, jerseys 1, 2 and 3 have all claimed tries. And Keebra Park now lead 12 points to nil. Goes over, they've changed kickers. This time Dave Talia has got the keys to the kicking duties. This time he sails it just over the crossbar. And Keebra Park, well, as you said, bang, bang, bang. And all of a sudden, Palm Beach trailing behind 14 points to nil. A better kick. Spiraling kick, this one. A good charge on to the footy. First up for Keebra Park. A relatively young football side. A penalty. There's a few calls last week, a few decisions last week from Palm Beach, you know, reflected but poorly on their discipline as well. So that's, I think, one of the key messages. I was just mentioning before the penalty was awarded, Keebra Park, a young football side, a number of year 11s playing this year, including the likes of Lachlan West, who scored a try. He's in year 11 this year. Herman Tofeano is a year 11 player, as is Blake Moser and Seth Nicotimo as well. So they've got another year, and this year the journey for them is going to be all the best for 2021. You know, they're going to become better footy players as they work the ball before turning it back on the inside. Fancy footwork. Gun James. Buddy's been given away, given the way a penalty for an obstruction is the call, and a reprieve for Palm Beach Currumbin. They'd be loving this as they kick downfield. As you can see, the car park, the Southport Leagues Club side of the field, full of people wanting to catch a glimpse of the action in the flesh, this Gold Coast derby. Oh, now Palm Beach Currumbin, a bit of a sloppy play there. Priestley picks it up. And now they'll play into Keebra Park territory. Rivett choosing to run the ball like he did last week. But he'll go to ground now. 32 metres away. They've had no football. Has Udebergen, lovely. Run straight through the markers. That's a fantastic scoot from the number 9. And all of a sudden, they're 15 metres away as Willison goes into acting half. Rivett to Weaver. Out the back. Through to Duckett. In the line. Back inside again. Scored a try last week, and he's oh so close. In fact, no, he isn't. Oh, no, he is close. I thought the referee was going to point to the spot then. Willison with the ball. Gets the arm free. Can he offload? And the answer's no. Call held. Last tackle for Palm Beach Currumbin. Udebergen goes to Weaver. Kicks a grubber nicely. Picked up there by West. And here he goes. Well, he goes to ground. He lost the battle against Xavier Savage, I think, is on the far side of the field. Nice idea from Weaver, trying to force a repeat set, but the fullback was looming. And now all of a sudden, second tackle, and they're all already 35 metres out from their own line. This is Tavali Kamparira. The late change from the centres out to the back row. Tavali Kamparira, of course, his older brother, Alafana, part of the side in 2017, part of the national final. At the moment, killing it in Gold Coast A grade for the Burley Bears. He scored 3 doubles in as many weeks. So a pretty talented football family, the Kamparira family. Last tackle, he's in front. In front of the kicker. And another penalty given away to Palm Beach. Off the back of penalties. Ball sails into touch on the eastern side of the field. And again, another opportunity for Palm Beach to attack, trailing on the scoreboard. Who would have thought in this Gold Coast derby that it would have been such a runaway early on? Palm Beach would love to get some points as we are about to venture into the final 10 minutes of this first half. Udebergen, Weaver, and now for Willison. Penalty, another penalty. Inside the 10 will be the call, I reckon. We're about 25 metres away from Keebra Park's line. It's Currumbin. Set up through the hands. Some fresh legs on. Parker Bryant just took the carry. Now for Bailey Martin. Right under the posts. About 5 metres away as Udebergen goes to the left. Weaver shows once, twice, bounces over and scores. They needed the try, Palm Beach Currumbin, and they look to their half. Tom Weaver again. A lovely show and go from him. Bounces off defenders and crosses over for a try. Palm Beach Currumbin's first. Then we've got St. Mary's in fourth, Marsden fifth, both those sides on 2 points, and Ipswich yet to win a game. Realistically, all sides have got to be on point because there's only 5 rounds. So here we go. At 14 points to 6, Palm Beach Currumbin now have got to come off the back fence. But they do now have points on the board as Bryant plays the ball. Good carry from Willison. Making meters back to now Oscar Bryant, who is on the park. Not sure, I'm assuming the Bryant boys might be related, and Oscar and Parker. They are. They've been told by the locals as Weaver takes a line on again. Well, gets it late offload. He pushed the offload, and now here's a breakaway. Dave Talia tries to run away with it. Not to be, but they turn over possession only 30 metres away. Now for Gunn James. Through the middle of the park. More fresh legs. Blake Moser on the field. They've just got to tighten up the middles here, Palm Beach Currumbin. Keebra slipping through, particularly the middle of the park. They go to this left edge again. Buller, he's already scored one tonight. They get him around the legs, does Rivet. Quick play of the ball. West acting half. Goes to Takani. Now for Gunn James. Up the park again. Breaking through the middle third of defensive line for Currumbin. Here's the last now for Keebra Park. Out the back, through the hands. Takani goes to Talia. Kicks picked up though by Currumbin. And defensively this time, they're able to keep their opposition out and looking to scoot quickly. Good carry there for Palm Beach Currumbin. Trailing 14 points to 6. Still plenty of time in this first half. Daniel Butterini with the footy. Plays it, Bryant in a dummy half. Great run there from, I believe it's Russell on the park now. Bryant again trying to catch the markers. Were they square? Referee Sam Swift was happy with them. Last tackle coming up for PBC now. They'll go out the back, Rivet. Kicks high. West is there out the back. Has to do a bit of work. It bounces. It's touched his foot. So it stops it from going dead. And now carries the ball forward. So a good set there from Palm Beach Currumbin. End-to-end footy so far. Some early penalties. Each side trying to find their groove in this round four contest. A dominant tackle there as Levi Jones is pushed back, and all of a sudden now, 10 metres outside their own line. They've got a muscle up here, but that's a good carry from you-know-who, Gunn James, and a penalty. And back chat. Well, another disciplined penalty goes in the way. Barker Bryant's had something to say to Sam Swift, and all of a sudden now a penalty's awarded. And for ourselves, if we're going to give away silly penalties. T. Carney now kicking for touch on the eastern side of the park. Now Keebra Park, every time they've had possession here, a set of six inside Palm Beach's line, they've been able to work their magic and score points as they play the footy again. Drop it on the inside. Now for Jake Parker, making his debut this afternoon in the Alan Langer Trophy. Out to Takani. Takes a line on both halves. Happy to run the ball to the line, which is good to see. Nice and direct play from your halves pairing, which is a huge asset in the side for, Parker again, second carry of the set. Through the hands. Talaya. Getting his hands dirty on the last tackle now. Adamson, slow play of the ball. Gets it out the back to Carney. Goes high. Looking for contest there. Backwards was the call, and Reece Somerville picks it up. And it was touched by Keebra Park. So a seven tackle set coming from for Palm Beach here. About 15 metres out from their own line. It was a good carry. To work out of their own end. Bryant to Weaver, turns it on the inside again. Working the left-hand side of the field. Trailing on the scoreboard at the moment, Bryant coming at a dummy half. And just an error. The call is a Keebra Park knock-on, so the ball went backwards. So it'll actually be Palm Beach's ball. Nevertheless, doesn't matter because Palm Beach have got the footy. And Rivet goes to ground. 2.5 minutes remain in this first half of footy. Parker Bryant looking to play it to his brother. We go back on the inside. That is a good shot there from Carpriero, who puts the shot on. No, it wasn't. It was, in fact, Blake Moser who put the shot on from Keebra Park. Well done to him. Now for Albedino. No real structure. Not working to the left or the right here. Just all over the place. That's not too bad to play unstructured footy. They're chasing points. They wouldn't mind another try. If Keebra Park can get a win here, they'll leapfrog Palm Beach Currumbin. And depending on the result between Wavell and St. Mary's. What an almighty clash. That'll be next week. Now the last tackle coming up here for Palm Beach. Bryant, dummy half, goes out to Weaver, kicks. Not quite sure if it was as pinpoint as he wanted it to be. And the flag goes up on the eastern side of the park. If Keebra Park can get a win here, they'll leapfrog Palm Beach Currumbin. And depending on the result between Wavell and St. Mary's. What an almighty clash. That'll be next week. Now the last tackle coming up here for Palm Beach. Bryant, dummy half, goes out to Weaver, kicks. Not quite sure if it was as pinpoint as he wanted it to be. And the flag goes up on the eastern side of the park. And that'll be half time, was where that happened. But anyway, we get underway. Second half action, a high kick from Palm Beach Currumbin. They'll chase it and they'll get the ball back. What a spectacular start to the second 30. Wowee! And they are only now 5 metres out from their own from Keebra Park's line. Bryant to Bryant in the middle of the park. Parker Bryant goes down underneath the black dot. Only 5 away. And a penalty. Working him in the tackle, hand on the ball. Trying to slow things down. Would you have expected that in the start of the second 30? The answer for me would have been no. I would not have expected that at all. Oh no. Well, not what you want. Off the penalty. Coach Brad Davis at half time. There's Keebra Park now. Played through Moser. Trying to get out of their own ends at the moment. Now the middle of the park. As the artificial light starts to take full effect here at Owen Park. Cooling down a little bit. It's 22 degrees at the moment. Not too much of a breeze. It was certainly gusty earlier on for the Kevin Walters Cup, where Keebra Park just got the victory in the dying seconds of that clash. Now they'll run it here. There's Talia, kicks downfield. They'll work the ball out of their own half here. Palm Beach Currumbin. That's a good carry though. Right on halfway. They'll work the ball. Savage, he's been quiet first half. Maybe a chance now for the Canberra Raiders contracted winger. And a penalty awarded the QRL's statewide competitions high performance unit referee wise. He refereed the Hastings during Cog Grand Final last year, did Sam. So you've pretty much got one of the best referees in the state in control of this game. As Palm Beach Crumber now played. Here's Weaver through to Butterini on the left hand side of the field. That's where Keebra Park scored there. 3 tries in the opening half down this left-hand edge. It's Willison. Great carry from him. Drags defenders with him, and he ends 5 metres away from the line. Another penalty. Well, that's now 3 for Palm Beach Currumbin in very consecutive sets. I reckon the warning is being issued now to the boys in blue. As the tackle is made. Another one. This will be in the bin, you would think. So here we go. They load up again. They had the weight of possession in this second half. That's high. And here we go. And he'll be in the bin, this one. I think that's that was going to happen. Unfortunately for Willison, he just got him a little bit too high. Having to sit down for, I believe it's 5 minutes, the sin bin in this competition. It's Rivet. Goes through. No, it is 10. So I've been informed it is 10. Sadly, that's going to be a big loss for Keebra Park now. 12 men for the next 10 minutes, and he was really dynamic in the 5-8 jersey. Now for Albedino on the right-hand side of the park. And they'll go out. Rivet choosing to run the ball. Links in with Weaver. A short ball. Butterini opened it underneath the... Over the line, I should say, not underneath the post, over the line, getting a little bit too keen myself, but they went out the back. Good link, Rivet to Weaver. Oh, just through the right upright. Makes it 2 from 2 tonight, Tom Weaver, and all of a sudden, Connor Takani restarts things. High kick. Taken well, though. And they're going to muscle up here. They were stripped. Another penalty. Any more penalties and further players will be sitting out. So here they go. Muscling up. Willison looking for the quick play of the ball. So here we go, a bit of a disagreement, now push and shove. Not sure why. So you can hear the words there from Sam Swift telling him to play the football. So both sides heated as you'd expect. Well, it is the Gold Coast Derby, so you'd expect both sides to muscle up in this game, playing it to Bryant. Now Weaver, back on the inside. Butterini, the try scorer. Goes to ground now. 8 metres after his own line. Bryant again, fires the ball away. As Rivet drops it on the inside. And now for Russell. He plays it quickly. Bryant, coming out of dummy half, runs through towards the B defender there. It's Blake Moser. Here's the last tackle for Keebra Park now. Out of dummy half, Savage takes it on his own, tries to get to the line. He's underneath the sticks, but he's not right at the chalk. So it'll be a turnover, not the worst place to turn the footy over. And Keebra Park now, a big yardage set expected here from to get out of their own end. Having to play with 12 men for another, I reckon, 3 minutes. One try conceded through that. Dave Talia at the moment having a little bit of a rest, just a number of consecutive penalties. There's been plenty of penalties in this game. It's Keebra Park, another good carry there from their prop forward. And a dummy half, Gunn James. Equally in the middle of the park, he's been fantastic as the lock forward for Keebra Park. Moser out the back. Goes to Takani. He goes high, but out on the full. And all of a sudden, it's momentum is a funny game. It's a funny thing in rugby league. So now for Daniel Butterini. He's really stood up in this second 30 minutes. Play it Savage. I think he's been told to get more involved. Making his A-grade debut, I believe, on the weekend too for the Tugan Seahawks in that narrow win in Gold Coast A-grade. Breaks the line as Ryan Foran, and he's about 9 metres away. Bryant left there short here. A long ball, and Duckett will score. He scored a number of tries last week. He scored one try, sorry, try assist, and the fullback ends up on the wing, and Palm Beach take the lead. 16 points to 14, kick to come. Izzy lines up to strike it. It looks good. It looks better than the kick before, which was a bit further out. They now kick downfield here on the restart. And they want to complete their set of six, playing it very, very quickly. A lovely scoot out of dummy half. The ladder leaders all of a sudden back in the lead here in the Gold Coast Derby. As Bryant is able to offload. Here they go again. That's Oscar Bryant, I believe his brother. And they're just making meters here now. Butterini. Another good run from him. Wants the footy is Oscar Bryant. They go through to Weaver, out the back. Savage, a long ball. It's Duckett again. Can he get two tries in as many minutes? He does. Ball down. Troy Duckett gets his second. And Palm Beach further extend their lead. Can Weaver make it four from four? It's been an ace so far with the boot. This one, this time. Sprays right of the right upright. Scores remain 8 points difference, 22-14. Good news for them though, Dave Talia back on. And he's kicked it out on the full. Well, this game is a tale of two halves. You would think that looking at the form, both sides have gone out the back at half time and swapped jerseys and gone, boys, well, to fool everyone, we'll swap jerseys here, because it was just error after error from Palm Beach in the opening 30, and all of a sudden Keebra Park, who just made error after error. They're going to muscle up here, Lavia. He's going to want to repay that 10 minutes on the sideline, but a breakaway. Here he is, Russell, straight through the middle of the park, and now Rivett trying to rip through him. All of a sudden, Palm Beach Currumbin's middle third. It happened last week as well against Ipswich. They had a second half scare, Keebra Park. A kick from Savage again. Chases there, I think. The ball was touched from Palm Beach Currumbin. Grounded in the in-goal area. It'll be a restart through a dropout. And again, it was a kick from him early in the count. They'll restart play here now. High. Taken by Savage. Now, ball through, Foran runs back inside. Oh, they've lost the ball though. Lost the ball. Keebra Park, if you're a fan of that powerhouse here on the Gold Coast, then don't write the game off yet. We know how their performance the years gone by. I think the national final a few years ago, 2017 I think it was, when they lost out, was it by a conversion? It was very close. They lost out in the national final. It might have been the 16 national final was they lost out, and of course 2017 they won it. So game, anything can happen in a game of footy, particularly schoolboy footy here on the News Corp Network. Fourth tackle now. They're 10 outside halfway. They're going to kick it. Lavia goes downfield. Savage has to get on his bike. Some great kick chase here from the left-hand side of the field, including Buller. They put some pressure on the fullback, Savage. But we know that he has got a big motor and some very fast feet. They've jammed them in here, this on the right-hand side of the park, though, Keebra Park. So they're going to muscle up a defence here and try and win back the territory game, because so far PBC have basically had themselves parked down. They've had the handbrake on. Oh, a forward pass, an error. An error from Palm Beach. Currumbin gives Keebra Park a sniff. You know, you don't have to score points every play. Neither every set. Just control the game nicely here as they go out the back. I believe that's PJ Potasi. A late inclusion for Keebra Park. They'll go out. Lavia, a short ball to Khan Pereira. And he goes to ground now, only about 5 metres away. In a dummy half, Moser gets the ball free. Oh, so close to the try line. Looking at options, does Moser. He goes out to Lavia. Now through a great ball, but he's denied. A second rower. It was a good angle from them. They go out. It's been touched there by Palm Beach Currumbin. So it'll be six more in the way of Keebra Park, a scrum the pack. So they come out. That's Lavia. Out the back nicely is West. Slavia gets into acting half. Now for Potassi. Quickly plays it. Lovely work from him. Moser coming in a dummy half. Beautiful J-line from him, but he's denied again. Potassi acting half. Fires it out. Takani goes inside. Matalavia Booth trying to use his pure strength to get over the line. He's denied. Pushing second effort. So they restart the tackle count. Of course, there's no six again. It's just a straight penalty here in these schoolboys. Alan Langer, trophy gun James now. Looking to play it quickly. Wasn't successful. Lavia, a long ball out. He just has to catch and score. But he's been denied. Tamapo has been denied through a forward pass. The touch judge was right on the spot. Palm Beach now, they'll just want to complete this set of six. Here they go though. A good run off the back of the scrum. Plays it quickly. Well, gee, that marker wasn't square. The referee happy with it though. Lucky to get away with that one. I thought he might have been a touch flat and a poor play of the ball. Penalty goes. Not rolling away the signal. Rivet kicks for touch on the eastern side of the park. They need to score twice. Two scores they need, Keebra Park, and time is running out for them. As Brock Priestley back on the park now for Palm Beach Currumbin. Through the hands. Wrapping up. Currumbin, Willison to Bryant. And now this is Bailey Martin, who's also back on the field. So we're seeing the changes with the starting 13 to come back on the park for their second stint. That's a breakaway here from Albertino down the right-hand side of the field. Numbers inside, but they reckon he got the ball down. No, knocked on over the goal line, and it'll be a 20-metre restart. He just couldn't thread the needle at the end of the day. And a seven-tackle set for Keebra Park. End-to-end stuff, edge of your seat, footy, which is what we want to see here on the News Corp Network. Now they're through. Buller, I think it is, on the halfway line. Well, that's a penalty. Priestley. Way too slow in that effort. He earned the quick play of the ball, Jareem Buller. They'll kick for touch. Flag goes up on the eastern side of the field. 5.5 remain. Here they go. Kobe Wood it is. Takani. Acting half with Moser at first receiver. Gets it back out to Lavia. Through the hands. West into a gap. Puts the foot down and scores his second. Well, they're back in at Keebra Park. Lachlan West scores his second. Lovely ball. Moser started the play there at first receiver. Got the ball away to Lavia, who has been to Leah, who has been very, very busy. He just couldn't thread the needle at the end of the day. And a seven-tackle set for Keebra Park. End-to-end stuff, edge of your seat, footy, which is what we want to see here on the News Corp Network. Now they're through. Buller, I think it is, on the halfway line. Well, that's a penalty. Priestley. Way too slow in that effort. He earned the quick play of the ball, Jareem Buller. They'll kick for touch. Flag goes up on the eastern side of the field. 5.5 remain. Here they go, Kobe Wood it is. To Carney. Acting half with Moser at first receiver. Gets it back out to Lavia. Through the hands, West into a gap. Puts the foot down and scores his second. Well, they're back in at Keebra Park. Lachlan West scores his second. Lovely ball. Moser started the play there at first receiver. Got the ball away to Lavia, who has been to Leah, who has been very, very busy. Dave Talia, I wouldn't have wasted too much time. It wasn't a bad effort from him. But it's waved away. 4 points, the difference. Or errors, if we have set after set. Here we go, the restart. And Moser. In a dummy half. Looking for offloads. Very flat here on the right-hand side. Not too much shape early on. They'll give it away to Calm Pereira. Tries to break the line. But Duckett gets in to make the tackle around the ball, as does Weaver. There's Penny. To Leah. Tries to break three. Plays it quickly. Moser through the hands again. Gunn James. Ball has hit the deck. Picked up by Buller. On the left-hand side to Jones. And into touch. Oh, gee, that pass looked forward. Huge error. Wowee. Their clash against Marsden next week. They said, righto, let's have a bit of fun with some goal line defence. What can Keebra Park come up with here? Talia straight through. Breaks the line. A good tackle. Offloads. Penny goes to grounds. Plays it back to West. Now for Buller. Will we have a fairy tale finish? They go through. Tofeono. Oh, so close to the line. They get numbers around the ball. Plays it to Moser. To Leah. Out the back. A little bit of confusion. The flick pass out to Tamapo goes down, quickly plays it. Penny out to Moser. They're going to use the line. This is now Madalavea Booth. Wrapped up. Last chance now for Keebra Park. 15 seconds remain on the clock. Moser out of dummy half. Will he be denied? Yes, he will. Well, that will, you would think, be the ball game. An enterprising last set. The boys want to get jiggy with it. I think Keebra Park know that. That will probably be the end. The siren sounds. They'll split this up. I'm not sure whether the referee heard that was the full-time siren. He does hear it. And that is the end of an enterprising 60 minutes of footy. And Palm Beach Currumbin come from behind. They were down 14-0. In the early stages of the match, but they've come out firing in the second half to win 22 points to 18 here at Owen Park. The Sun.